Jenny Towne is a research analyst with the Simpson Center here in Washington. She's also the managing editor of the website 38 North, which analyzes events on the Korean Peninsula. Jenny, thanks so much for coming in.
Sure.
As we mentioned, this is the first time a DPRK leader has visited Vietnam in 55 years. How significant is that?
I think it's really a sign of the changing times and how well that North Korea has worked to rehabilitate their image over the past year. It's been quite interesting to watch and quite shocking, actually, how quickly the world has really embraced them as they've opened the doors.
Mm-hmm. And during that summit between Kim and Trump, as you know, Trump praised Vietnam's quote-unquote thriving economy and advised North Korea to follow that as a model. How likely do you think that will be?
Well, certainly there are plenty of models that North Korea has been looking at and plenty of lessons for them to learn. I think, you know, the biggest lesson that they have to try and figure out is how to get ahead of the system rather than being behind and trying to pull things back. So instead of being adaptive to how to manage that change, but they really have to make some very very decisive strategic changes in order to do that. And I think we've seen some signs that Kim Jong-un is willing to, but is still holding back for the how do we maintain control throughout this process.
Yeah, it's not an easy process to just change and switch gears that way.
Yeah, and especially because it will require a real focus on, you know, building financial institutions, building the type of technical capabilities to do the statistics and the numbers that are needed, and things that Vietnam went through, that China went through, in order to try and normalize those relations and normalize those practices. So, you know, North Korea's been dabbling, but has not yet made those decisions to really work on the institutions that would be needed in order to sustain this type of process.
Yeah, it wouldn't happen overnight for sure. Well, Vietnam is, a former wartime enemy of the U.S. Mm-hmm. That now has good relations. So do you think the DPRK could follow that path potentially?
Well, what's interesting is that, you know, North Korea actually fought with Vietnam against the Americans during the Vietnam War and were sort of against Vietnam negotiating peace. So it is kind of a whole different world right now. And certainly the U.S. has shown that they can have, you know, they can change the nature of relationship over time. It often takes a very long time to do so. And we've seen, you know, an attempt over the past year to really work on that relationship and try and test things. We've made a little progress. It's hard to say after Hanoi how well that is going to be sustained. Although with South Korea pushing for this, you know, certainly the attention will still be on the issue, but it's hard to say how far we can really go.
What was your reaction to the summit and how it ended up?
It was quite surprising to find out at the end of the summit how far away we really were from getting a deal, because I think the early indications were we were very close and just had a few more details to work out. But it sounds like, you know, both sides took the opportunity in Hanoi to add a little extra. But that little extra was actually a lot. And so, you know, playing high stakes poker when you're in such a high profile environment is not necessarily the most advisable plan. And certainly it didn't work out. Both sides left the door open for continuing negotiations. But given the current political climate, and especially in the United States, it's hard to see how we maintain that, especially at the pace that we have before. And if we keep going, you know, if we're really going to be able to come to a consensus on where to even start the process.
Mm-hmm. Another thing that will not happen overnight, for sure. Another thing, let's go back to Vietnam. We saw huge crowds in that video greeting Kim Jong-un during his visit to Hanoi. What effect do you think this visit will play on the relationship between Vietnam and North Korea?
Well, already, they've talked about normalizing their economic relations and trying to improve. They've had a little bit rocky relations over the past decade or so. And so I think all of the ASEAN countries are really looking now as to how to pull North Korea into the mix and how to help them in that process. Vietnam is at the, you know, forefront of that. And we've heard similar stories from like Thailand and Cambodia as well. So I think you will see greater exchanges between these two leaders going forward and greater economic cooperation that will start to burgeon up, and depending on how the sanctions story goes as well, of course.
Well, thanks for putting it all in perspective. Jenny Towne with the Simpson Center, also a managing editor of the website 38 North. Thanks for your perspective.
Thank you.